Hey, everybody, welcome back. So, we're gonna continue venturing on. I already made some progress. Some progress has been made. Not a lot, but some. We're just gonna keep going. Going our jaunty little jog. Try not to fall down. Oh, God. Oh, heavens no. Okay, calm down. Calm down. Okay, cool. Yeah, jump for joy. Oh, I wanted to pick it up. Son of a biscuit. Oh my god. That is my... That would be my reaction to that. Goddamn, dude. There's a bunch of shit over there. But we're almost at our weight.
Heads up, Sam.
Yeah.
Your cargo's been pinged. Move. Now, before someone has eyes on you.
Oh, shit.
Get to your destination ASAP if you don't want to get caught.
Okay. Okay. That's why the caution signs are here then. Cool. Got it. Wonderful. Shit. Oh, he's all the way down there. Holy shit. Okay. Alright. Okay. I'm assuming those are the homo demons. I see some strandings. How's BB? BB, you doing good? Yeah, you're fine. All right, don't worry, BB. We're gonna make, as long as we got each other, we'll be fine. Oh, man. Oh, my God. He's fucking hauling ass to me. Shit. Oh, it's a rope. Okay. I'll give you all the fucking likes in the world. I just need to get the fuck out of here. So what pings them to me? That's my question. Is it me pinging things? Because that would make sense. Okay. Bit of a sheer cliff that you left me on, but all right, I understand. It's what you had. Okay, all right. Eh. Where's my destination? I've lost it. Shit. Oh my god. Oh wow. I guess up there, and then to me. Yeah. Okay. Alright, it's a bit of Assassin's Creed-y type of thing, right? Where it's like, you gotta get out of their line of sight. I also don't know what those are. That thing, that glowy thing. Oh no. What happened? Oh, the time fall's happening. Why are they dancing? Oh no. I've seen the cutscenes. I know that is bad. Fudge. Time follow accelerate pet. Yeah, no, I get it. Also, they will signify BTs, right? Up. Keep going upwards. I'm assuming that's what that means. Backup fuel, way station west of Capital City. Alright, just throw that shit on my back. Alright, might as well use the terminal. Deliver lost cargo. It's two things, but it weighs a lot. So... it works out. Cargo is entrusted to another player. Good. A lot of miscellaneous. Also, bridge link. Hell yeah, I guess. Cool. It's a lot off our back. That's the big thing. I see y'all strandings. Metals are down there. Metals are up here. I'm falling. Start to tip a little bit. It's fine. Grab that shiz, put it on your back. No, stop fucking goddamn falling, Norman. There's stuff down here. Stop. Oh shit, stop running. Okay. Stop falling, goddammit. Resins are useful. Running downhill over these crag rocks, not great. That's how I can bust my skull and hurt BB. Yo, car. No, I get it. Stop with the cargo bullshit. I understand. Don't worry. Put that on my back. Yoink. Falling over. Falling over again. Alright, now we have some... what? Uh-oh. What? What? I don't like it. What is happening? Oh, no. Scan for BTs. When you found, when you're connected to BB, there are points stores that the closest BT in a certain range. Okay. Alright, so we... oh, no. I gotta pay attention to him, the falling over and BTs? Well, that's not great for me. Also, it's raining. Shit's getting destroyed. Fudge, man. I see you. I don't like that. Oh no. Yo, drink the monster energy. Get more energy, man. Like right behind me. Oh shit, I'm holding my breath. Shit, stop it. Carry it all on your back. Norman, get off of me. Leave my baby alone. Oh, I've been... yeah, you know what's increasing? My death. Hi! BB? Daddy's got you, don't worry. I'm trying, BB, don't worry. I, like, dropped all my shit because I got attacked. Grip for balance. Yo, I'm holding my breath. You can't get me while I'm holding my breath. Jump, Norman. Norman, climb, you little bastard. Climb. BB. BB. Do not worry. Okay. No. No, it's okay, baby. No, do not stop soothing that baby, goddammit. Am I doing anything? BB, is this helping? It's alright. Soothing will stop BB from crying and reduce stress levels. Don't worry that we almost died. It's fine. Don't worry your pretty little brain about it. Go back to sleep. It's okay. Dad's got you. Okay. I wonder if people have found out, like, a way to, like, rhythmically do this. Where, like, it's the best way to do it. It gets the most bars. This nap time brought to you by the letter M, the letter T, and the letter N, as well as the letters D, the letters E, and the letter W. Maybe don't flip the baby. I'm just gonna say that right now. All right. That could have been fucking terrible. Again?
Something wrong, Sam?
I don't know. Kid doesn't look so hot.
Nothing to worry about. Its functions are temporarily suspended, but they can be restored. I can perform the necessary maintenance at a distribution center. Hurry, though.
Everything is going tits up. There's a car. How far am I? Not far, not too far. Actually, we're right here. Ah, fucking Christ, Sam. Oh! Fucking Christ! Stand up! Stand up! No! 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 You come back here right now! Come back here this instant, goddammit! Come back here this... Shit! Okay. I got this. I got this. I'm gonna get. That was on purpose. That was on purpose. Okay. You got me. That shit. On purpose. I needed to fall down to get in front of my cargo. On purpose. Got that. Do I have everything that I need? Because I don't deliver all of it. Fuck. 5 rare metals, yes. That's what I needed. Okay. No, we got it. We good. be good, bait. Well, baby's not good. That's a problem. Yes.
When the strain on your BB exceeds sustainable levels, it triggers the production of harmful compounds, and the body, in essence, begins to attack itself. It's called autotoxemia. If your BB's not performing to spec, drop by your private room and see if the incubator helps.
Motherfucker, I am legit miles away from my private room, unless this one's got one. Which, this does look like an official center, so maybe I'll have a room here. I think everything happened for a reason. Well, not a reason, but on purpose. You know?
Scanning bridges ID. Verifying ID.
Like, oh, they attack. And then the BTs attack. And then you're... That's supposed to force your baby to misfire. Babies do that, right? They misfire. I know that. I know this. I'm an adult. I took parenting classes in school and such. Good welcome sign. Holy shit. This was a harrowing journey. 6 out of 6. Minimum of 6. Fuck yeah, me. It's all probably destroyed and useless. But, hey. The delivery is made. You can't talk shit on me. You did not pay the shipping and handling.
Wake station folks told me all about you. Sam Bridges. With the second expedition, right? The guy expanding the chiral network on his lonesome. When he's not out making deliveries. So what'd you bring us? Let's see it. Talk about above and beyond. Thanks. Must have had to pass through BT territory to get here too, didn't you? They weren't joking when they said you were a legend.
Can you help my baby? Well, the rain hit. Yeah, you can't blame that on me. It was the rain, man. I traveled a long way to get here. I'll have you know that. Like I said, a long way. S rank. Can you get lower? I guess you could if you have destroyed cargo. Not even 3 stars yet, you son of a bitch. Well, delivery volume go up. That's good. I did good.
Okay, it's time.
Time for what?
Connecting us to the network.
Oh, that thing. Sorry, there are more concerning matters on my brain. The thing to my chest having autotoxemia. Being a big one. Most of the East Coast done. We're spreading into the middle of the country. That's good.
Sam.
Yep, that's me.
As always, thanks for bringing more folks into the UCA.
Good talk, dead man, die hard man. As more facilities join the UCA, Bridges HQ will be able to provide additional functionality. Those facilities, such as the ability to fabricate equipment and weapons via delivery terminal. The range of available weapons and equipment may increase, and new terminal functions and information may be added as things progress. Mules and drones syndrome. Bridge babies. Timefall. Interview data. New features have been added to the cufflinks. Mail. Data. New option has been delivery terminals. Recycle. Whoa. That is the chiral network. Cool. Neighborly see and access other player structures. Cool.
Looks like we're on the chiral network. And with those materials you brought for our chiral printer, we can produce supplies for you here as needed. Think of it as our way of returning the favor. Now head west and keep on doing what you do.
Can I rest a little bit?
Good. The distro center is on the network.
Sam, do me a favor. Take your BB to a private room and connect it to the incubator.
Two of you could fit on one of those? I didn't know that. I thought it was like a one-to-one thing. Please. I need my baby to be fixed.
Dead man, you there? Little help.
Okay, Sam. Remove the pod and connect it to that incubator.
It's in.
Good. A temporary excess of stress. Easily addressed if we return it to its mother's womb.
Mother?
Located in the capital, not city, ICU. Brain dead, of course.
You mean still mother?
Correct. A still mother's womb facilitates a connection between the world of the dead and the BB. And you, in turn, connect yourself to a BB, granting you the ability to sense BTs. These pods were designed to simulate the conditions inside a still mother's womb. BBs need to believe they're in one at all times to function properly. However, we can only maintain this deception for so long, which is why we must periodically update the environmental data by synchronizing it with a still mother via the chiral network. There. The update is in progress. Right now, the pod is synchronizing with the Steel Mother in Capital Knot City and reconfiguring its settings based on the latest data. Returning your BB to the womb in this manner will temporarily reduce its stress levels. That being where it technically belongs, of course.
Kid looks happy.
I'll try adjusting the oxytocin dosage. Autotoxemia should set in much slower from now on. You should remember that BBs are just equipment. Try not to get attached. Each one has been physically removed from its steel mother's womb, a process that renders them unpredictable and prone to failure. No BB on record has remained in service for over a year. It may need to be retired before this expedition is over.
And then? You saying there's no way to keep my BB alive?
You must understand, there is still a great deal we don't know about BBs. As we expand the chiral network and recover more past data, perhaps we'll find our answers. Right. You asked me to look into why the BTs might be reacting to your blood. I spoke with Hartman. We should have your results soon. Anyway, get some rest. You and your BB are both exhausted. Good night, Sam.
Why do you need to handcuff yourself to the bed every night? A little weird to me.
London Bridge is falling down.
I don't like this.
Can you see me?
How are things over there?
Still not under guard. Still not chained up. Still can't leave. But if you can keep making connections, if you can get to me, we can go back east, back home. Thank you. I mean that. It's bad. There are fewer and fewer people in the cities these days. No one's having children anymore. But humans aren't made for living alone. They're supposed to come together, to help one another. And if we as a people can't do that, if we can't reconnect, then, well, it's like Bridget said, extinction.
Come on. Rebuilding America isn't gonna get rid of the BTs. As long as they're still around, there's no escaping it.
But at least we'll have hope. I'll be waiting, Sam. Waiting for you. Come and find me.
Hello, Sam. This is Hartman. Since you're awake, it might behoove you to freshen up. To that end, why not take a shower? It's good for the body and soul, and also my research, as it happens.
You just want to see my Norman Peetus. Sitting on that joke for so long. Sitting on it for so long. I hope we get more info about still mothers. Because that sounds real fucked up. Fucking weird.
Any other people with dooms?
Everyone in Bridges, myself and Mama. Results thus far are inconclusive. But you possess other singular qualities, being a repatriate as well. I must confess to a measure of optimism.
Processing fluids, waste products, Kyrelli, dispensing.
There. Take the sample with you. Should the opportunity arise, try using it on a BT. I'm curious to see how they react. Who knows? It may even prove beneficial to you.
Throw your pee in some
there
of their faces.
There was an old research paper detailing the effects of bodily fluids from individuals like us on BTs. It is only by recovering these materials that we can unearth the knowledge of the past. Not just the Death Stranding. But also the mystery of your body's unique properties and even our doom's affliction. There may well be hope for humanity. Sam, I have no interest in rebuilding America. I want to recover the past.
Five, four, three, two, one.
For what?
After you make your connections and nothing happens, then what? I said then what?
Sam. Sorry to bother you while you're taking a break, but I figured you'd want to hear this. Hell, maybe it'll help you rest easier. We received a number of messages addressed to you. I've not taken a look myself, but I gather they're mostly from your clients. You should see if they contain any useful information. Mail can be accessed via your cufflinks, as well as the terminal in your private room. There's something else I'd like to share with you. With the Chiral Network, we now have the power to reclaim our past. Data once thought lost forever from every corner of America can be pieced back together from fragmented records. Our archives are still a work in progress, of course. But as we expand the network and integrate more way stations and cities, we'll be able to recover more and more information, such as the previous expedition's logs and reports. Everything they sent back was lost when Central Knot City was destroyed. Now, we've managed to restore some already, in fact. You can access them from a private room terminal or your cufflinks by selecting Archives. Might make for interesting reading.
And lore. All right, let's take a look. Benjamin Hancock. Sorry, Sam, bad news. Thanks for delivering some rare metals. Sam, everyone at the Distro Center really appreciates you coming through for us. Thumbs up. I'm afraid I've got some bad news for you, though. The bike you saw outside, its battery's dead. You'll have to give it some juice if you want to use it. You only need to do it once, though. Auto charger should kick in after. Prayer hands. Sorry if we got your hopes up. Man, that was a second thought. I need my baby safe. And, I got some more bad news, too. Cry face. You see, different facilities have to work together, sharing materials so everyone gets what they need, and to make sure that everything that's produced gets put to proper use. That's why guys like you are so important. Without porters, the whole system falls apart. Whole world, even. Thumbs up. Anyway, there's this guy, George Batten, over at the way station. He used to be a reliable porter, but lately, it's like pulling teeth getting him to make even the simplest delivery. He's bitching about being scared or not having enough oxy or whatever. Always some excuse. Even when he does agree to make the run, he's liable to lose half his load en route. No shit. So, yeah, that's why we're a bit short of materials at the moment. I'm sure you'll, I'm sure you'll soon help us put that to rights. We're counting on you, Sam. And a bunch of thumbs ups. Ah, speaking of, George Baton. Sam the man, our savior. Things are looking up here at the way station. Everything feels better somehow. We were all bright-eyed and bushy-tailed when we set ourselves up, but 3 years of isolation and loneliness will change anyone's tune. Hell, when we first got here, we were putting up signs of porters and whatnot, but after a while, some guys got too scared to even set foot outside. When Central went up, I told myself this was it. America's done. Everyone was feeling it too, and the mood was just bleak. And then you waltzed on in. I know what you're thinking. At first, I thought it was just the oxytocin. But that's not it. Not all of it, anyhow. You gave us the glimmer of hope we needed to bring us into the Chiral Network. We get back into the game now. We're thinking of putting up signs again. Even watchtowers, too. Before long, we'll open up a new delivery route. Mark my words. It's scary out there, although all the oxy in the world won't help us deal with the mules, let alone BTs. We shit ourselves every time we catch sight of one and end up dropping half our equipment. Honestly, a part of me is still worried that we won't be able to keep it up. And that's why we need you, Sam. You're not scared of anything, right? Go show us how it's done. Yeah, you goddamn right I am. God, data. 70. Oh my god. Tips. I don't need this shit. In before I need this shit later. Goddamn, there is a lot of it. Sweet berry nutballs. Interviews. Oh my Jesus. Bridge babies. Timefall. I haven't met you yet. I haven't met you yet. Hartman. Die Hard Man, Dead Man, and Hartman. Can't wait for Mega Man to show up. Bridge's primary objective is to rebuild America. In order to rebuild, one of our main tasks is to connect cities and other settlements by reestablishing the delivery network. Back before the Death Stranding, the comms and delivery networks were what held society together. whole thing was automated. AI managed. The deliveries carried out by drone. The belief was that the people out of the equation would revolutionize the entire system. But things didn't quite pan out that way. Didn't think so. Instead, we started seeing cases of what would eventually be dubbed drone syndrome. It was too much for some folks to accept, leaving everything to machines and nothing to the common man. Is a man not entitled to the sweat of his brow? And indeed, the oxytocin deficiency and hormonal imbalances we confirmed seem to be back up that assessment. Humanity needed to be a part of the process. The laws were put in place, and we stepped back into the picture again. And then what happened? All the people put out of work by machines who got called up again convinced themselves society couldn't survive without them and brought a whole new disorder. Delivery dependence syndrome, they called it. When the Death Stranding tore us apart, the delivery problem spiraled even further. It wasn't helped by the fact that chiral clouds prevented planes and drones from flying, which meant we had to go back to relying completely on human couriers, whether we liked it or not. Eventually, delivering goods became all some lived for. They were obsessed, addicted, consumed by the desire to deliver. Over time, they turned into the mules we know and love today. Ah, so they want to hunt me down, take my packages. It's the trailer of the... Well, not, now I know mule. Knocking shit down and be like, it's mine, fuck you. Or something. Look, I'm kind of new here at Bridges, so I don't know if any of this will be useful to you. Still, I'm happy to talk about BBs, if that's what you want. They call me Dead Man on account of my familiarity with the dead. Get it? We've always been on good terms, you see. Used to have regular little chats back when I worked in the morgue. Ah, you're that person. Anyway, that's also the reason I work on BB maintenance and research, to learn more about those who are no longer with us. But I digress. Fact is, BBs were already being issued to our forces in the field before I joined Bridges. What's more, research into the little guys had already been conducted long, long ago, but no one took the plunge and put what they discovered to practice. What that did mean is that when Bridges wanted to build our own BBs, you don't build humans, but okay. Most of the work was already been done for us. We just needed to follow the instruction manual, so to speak. Which isn't to say that we have any idea how they work, not how they can detect BTs, or they can connect this world to the other side. We still have much to learn about our little friends, but one thing is certain. Their continued study will lead us to a greater understanding of the Stranding, and of life and death itself. That much, I can assure you. Well, I think that's about all I have to tell you today. Hopefully I'll have something new to share next time when we chew the fat. See you around, I guess. Timefall is first recorded when the Death Stranding occurred, and despite all the years that have passed since then, we are no longer to understanding how or why it accelerates the passage of time for the objects and organisms it touches, or why it immediately turns to ordinary water having done so. Some researchers have gone as far to posit this process as stealing time. As for why Timefall is observed only in certain places, all that we know for certain is that it is somehow affected by local chiral concentrations. This is merely a hunch, but something in me suspects that Death Stranding may have warped our perception of the passage of time. What? Huh? Not that necessarily a bad thing, you understand. We humans can conceive of our own deaths and even the possibility of a place beyond death, yes? We have the capacity to conceptualize the future and revolutionary advantage which aided our development as a species. Well, what if Timefall has given us a new supercharged version of this essential ability? One that will take us to the next stage of our evolution? Perhaps we wouldn't need to hole ourselves up in the not cities. Perhaps in time, the Death Stranding will come to be seen as a phenomenon that saved our species. Exciting thoughts, I'm sure you'll agree. I, for one, can't wait to set out on a journey. Who knows what awaits us? I think you're weird and crazy, and I think I remember you from the reveal trailer. That'll do it for this episode. It's been a harrowing-ass journey, so I want to thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, super kick that like button. check out my channel for more videos I have done. If you like what you see, hit the subscribe button. And until next time, goodbye.